Welcome to VLSI lecture series. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you VLSI design flow in this video. And to understand VLSI design flow, these are my session outlines, where first we will discuss basics of VLSI design flow, then we will see flowchart of VLSI design flow, then after I'll explain you how many domains are there with VLSI design flow. And with respect to domains, I'll explain you Y chart of VLSI design flow. So at the end, you can understand how VLSI designing that is been done step by step. So let us begin this session with basics of VLSI design flow. So see, VLSI design flow that starts with specifications. So design flow will start with the given sets of specifications or requirement. So with respect to specifications and requirement, we start our designing of VLSI design. So system should get designed with respect to given specifications. At the end, when desired specifications are not met, the design has to be modified and rechecked several times until it meets the required specifications. And as if design specifications are not met, in that case, we do some modifications every time. And once we have tolerable modification up to which it can work out properly with the given system, we go for fabrication of design. So let us see how flowchart is there with VLSI design flow. So it starts with design specifications. After that, we design that with respect to its structure. So architecture design is been done, where we define planning of that VLSI design. After that, we design that with bit more detail, where gate level designing is been there. So in gate level designing, we'll be having digital circuit functioning, which will be there at gate level design. And if you zoom in inside of this gate level design, there will be circuit level design. Right. So initially we will be having specifications, then we architect that design, and in architect of that design, inside there will be gate level design. And if you zoom inside of that gate level design, there will be circuits. And once we have circuit level design, we design that in HDL coding. So here there will be HDL coding. After HDL coding, we'll be doing simulation of that design. And once we simulate that, we do verification with respect to timing. So here we will be observing timing of entire simulation, and with respect to timing, output should be correct. And once we have proper verification, and if design is meeting to the requirement, then we end up with that design. But if that design is not meeting, in that case, again we do some modification in this HDL coding, and again we resimulate that and we re-verify that design. So if you observe this VLSI design flow, then initially we started with architecture design, then gate level design and circuit level design. And once we finalize circuit level design, we go for HDL coding and we do simulation and verification. And we do this process till we meet to the requirement, and once we meet to the requirement, we give it to fabrication. So this is how VLSI design flow is there. Now let us see the domains of VLSI design flow. So basically there are three main domains which is there with VLSI design flow. One is behavioral domain, second is structural domain, and third is physical domain. And we will see in complete detail how domains are there and how we do VLSI designing by having Y chart. So let us see Y chart, in which we have three domains, as I have told: structural domain, behavioral domain, and physical domain. So now when we start with VLSI design, we will be having specifications, and based on that we make algorithm in behavioral domain. And once we have algorithm in behavioral domain, that will be given to structural domain, and with respect to structural domain, there will be system assignment. So there will be system in structural domain, and with respect to assigned system in physical domain, there will be chief floor plan, and in that chief floor plan, there will be elevation of blocks and in those particular blocks we are dealing with to design IC, right? So in particular blocks you will be finding different working is been there, like there can be shift register, there can be counter, or there can be universal shift register. So these types of chip floor plan with different blocks is been assigned at physical domain. After that, in behavioral domain, again we go for finite state machine, and in finite state machine we justify how chip floor plan will transmit data with respect to time, and that timing assignment that should happen with respect to register which is there in structural domain, and that register data assignment should happen with respect to module placement which is there in physical domain. And after that module placement, we will be having module description in behavioral domain, and that module description will justify what will be logic gate diagram which is there in structural domain. And with respect to logic gate diagram, there will be cells placement. Now you'll be observing different logic gates are having different current driving capabilities. So with respect to need of fan in and fan out, we place different logic gates inside of that physical domain of cells placement. And at the end, after having cells placement in physical domain, we define Boolean equation in behavioral domain. And with respect to Boolean equations, in structural domain, there will be transistor which will be functioning and providing that operation of Boolean expression. And once it is justified, it is functioning properly, there will be masking, where in masking we provide connection which identifies working of integrated circuit. So that is how complete flow is there in VLSI design with three different domains: behavioral domain, structural domain, and physical domain. So this is all about Y chart of VLSI design, and with respect to this chart only, complete algorithm is been designed which will be identifying, planning, and assignment of very large scale integrated circuit. I hope that this video is helpful to you to understand how VLSI design flow is there. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. The reason is your suggestions matters to me, and based on that, in future I'll make videos which will be solving queries of the students. So please give your positive suggestions. Thank you so much.